guys, this is Stephanie and welcome back to Blue Ridge Farmstead. We're very excited about today's video. It's going to be all about our greenhouse build. We've been working on this project for about a week. Prior to that, there was lots of planning, lots of building of air castles of many greenhouses in the past, and finally this week we brought that dream to fruition. We are really, really happy with the way that it turned out. We're going to take you guys through the process and show you a little bit of each part of the process, the things that we did, and then at the end we will show you the final product and what it looks like and how we're going to use it. And then at the bottom in the description box below, we're going to give a breakdown of exactly what we spent on this greenhouse and tell you how you might be able to do that for yourself. All right, so stay tuned. Hey y'all, so we're at our local Lowe's. We're picking up the panels for our greenhouse. We're using the Tuftex crystal clear panels for this greenhouse. We are going to use the 8-foot sections for the sides of the greenhouse and then the 12-foot length sections for the top of the greenhouse.
Next time call Lowe's and have them prepare it.
Yeah. We recommend actually getting this online and having the order ready for pickup, because getting these panels out is maybe I should help. It's not been easy, and I fear that these 12-foot panels is probably going to be even more difficult. The other thing that we're purchasing is going to be these strip closures. These are, and this one's broken, I just picked it up. Okay, strip closures. So this is actually going to go in between the ripples to make sure that the greenhouse panels are secure and also sealed off. The strip closures are $5.98 each. The 12-foot panels are $32.97 each here at our Lowe's, and then the 8-foot panels are $21.98. So we're probably going to put about $400 into materials in this greenhouse. We'll keep you posted. So good. There's just a few places that we need to shore up and make sure that it's sealed off. Up here at the junction with the wall and the roof, that looks so good. Let's go back and look at the door. So this door we found in an old shed, and we're just recycling it, using it. It's going to be awesome back here. Okay, so this is the back side. So right now we're standing in the barn, and this greenhouse is a lean-to onto the barn. Lots and lots of space we're going to have in here.
I was just breaking up some wood and
breaking the ground.
Looks great. Wow, guys, this is exciting. We are coming to you from inside our completed greenhouse. We are so excited to have this addition to our farm done. Oh my gosh, we're gonna be able to have so many plants growing in here. So many more that we could not have growing in our mudroom in the house. I'm going to give you a quick tour of everything, and then down in the description box below, we're going to have a breakdown of the total cost that we have in this 8x10 structure. We are going to list the materials. So one of the things that we used was Tuftex, the panels that we used, those Tuftex panels that we got at Lowe's. We used some special roofing screws that my husband picked up. They have a little rubber washer on the back to prevent any leaking. And also, we're going to talk about the lumber that we used. We obviously did not have as much money in the lumber as someone who would not have access to rough cut lumber would. However, we can go through and talk about how many 2x4s and how many 2x6s we used, and then that way you can get a good idea of how much that would cost if you were to go and purchase those items at a hardware store, or Lowe's, or your local lumber yard. So let's get to this tour. So over here is our door. We had a reclaimed door that I found in an old shed. Over here is our baker's rack that we had in the house and all of the plants that we moved out. We did bring our grow lights just for now. We're expecting some cooler temperatures this week, and so I wanted to make sure that there was a little bit of heat in here. Over here I've got some more supplies, more potting materials. I've got some more cups and pots, and then we've got some, our seeds are on top, and then some more pots down below. And then back here I've got our potting bench. Now this is obviously not a potting bench. We are reusing an old industrial office table and our office desk. I've elevated it on cinder blocks and bricks so that it's waist high for me. So like, obviously if we were to use this where it would normally be sitting on the ground, it would be too low and I would be hunching over to try to get stuff into these pots. But we've elevated it up to waist height, and so now it's going to be really easy for me to pot in here. I don't have anything on this other wall, but we will have hopefully future shelves here where I can build some shelves here off of these 2x4s so that we can have some more plants. And then let me quickly take you out and I'll show you the outside, what the outside ended up looking like. So we'll walk this way. This is one side, and you can tell how we have attached this to the front of the barn. So we had three open bays on our barn, and we've attached this to the front of the one on the end. We've got a pretty good overhang here so that we won't have water gathering down on the ground here. So we've got enough room so that the water will run off. And we've actually got some plans and thinking that we may want to put a rain barrel on the corner of each of this each end of this greenhouse to catch some rain. And then here's the other side. So mad props to my husband. He did an incredible job bringing my design to life. I really just basically came out and said one day, like, I think we should put our greenhouse here, and this is kind of what I want it to look like. And he killed it. He killed this project. So we're all impressed. We're the family. Everybody's really impressed with my sweet husband. So
That's it, guys. Check the description box below for a breakdown of the cost. Just a rough estimate in my head, I'm pretty sure we have less than $400 in this greenhouse, because we actually bought a few pieces of material that we didn't even use and we're going to take back. So that's that. Thanks for watching, guys. We are really enjoying watching, really enjoying doing these videos and putting them out for you. We hope that you are enjoying them as well. If you like the content that we're putting out, please hit the like and subscribe button and comment below and share this with your friends. And we will see you in the next video. Take care.